Morocco's main Islamic groups have rejected plans to normalize ties with Israel following a deal brokered by the U.S. The religious branch of the co-ruling party, PJD, the Unity and Reform Movement also denounced all attempts at normalization and what it called the Zionist infiltration. Unlike its government coalition partners who backed the deal, it took the PJD 2 days to react amid divisions among the party's senior leadership. On Friday, Morocco's major opposition party, Adl Walisan, condemned normalization deals with Israel as a step in the back of the Palestinian cause. From Ramallah, I'm joined by Saad Nim, professor of political science with Versailles University. Good to have you with us, professor. Another country is just jumping in that bandwagon brokered by the U.S., normalizing ties with the Tel Aviv regime, but it looks like that again there is in the government there deciding and political parties.
Good afternoon for you and all your viewers. As a matter of fact, the relationship between Morocco and Israel is going way back in history. During the 60s, even and 70s, there was this kind of relationship. But apparently, because of the situation at that time, it was impossible for them to normalize the relationship officially. But it's quite clear now that the time has come and the Americans have put an enormous pressure on the Moroccan, and especially also promising them that they will recognize the Western Sahara as part of Morocco rather than independence of Western Sahara by Polisario. So what happened that the Moroccan had seized the moment and they normalized officially the relationship and recognized Israel officially. Now, inside Morocco itself, we know that the Moroccan people, mostly they are absolutely behind the Palestinian cause and they are supporting the Palestinians. And that's why we had, like in the last two days, more than 15 parties and groups in Morocco signing petitions and signing statements. They are denouncing this kind of relationship between Israel and Morocco, and most of the parties in Morocco, they are against this kind of move by the king as the relationship with Israel. We believe that the people in Morocco are going to do lots of troubles in the coming days. Morocco is not like other countries, like what happened in Emirates or in Bahrain, but or even in Sudan. But in Morocco, we believe that the people there will stand against this kind of action, but we don't know yet to what extent they can succeed in deterring the government and the king of going ahead with this normalization.
Okay, appreciate your comments and contributions. Saad Nim, professor of political science with Versailles University, joining me out of Ramallah.